Hey everybody, welcome to the Big Llama Show. I'm the Big Llama. Thank you so much for joining me. If this is your first time here, this is a movie reaction channel. And on this channel, we get to react to first time movie watches. Essentially, I get to watch the movies for the very first time. I give you my thoughts, my comments as I'm watching the movie. They're edited for YouTube, of course. And then immediately following the movie, I give you my full unedited reaction, my commentary of what I just saw and my thoughts about the movie in that exact moment. I don't do any prepping. I don't write things down. I just go off the top and let you know exactly what my thoughts are.
Don't think. Feel.
Immediately following that, I'll do some IMDb trivia. We'll go into IMDb. We'll look at the budget. We'll look at the box office. We'll look at a couple of juicy, you know, nuggets of information because I love movies. And that's why I started this channel, because I love movies. So guys, if this is your first time here, welcome to the channel. If you've been here before and you supported the channel, thank you so much for supporting. All right. Anyway, guys, if you have not read the description or seen the thumbnail, we are watching the 1964 movie From Russia with Love. This is the second movie in the James Bond series. I did Dr. No, so if you haven't seen it, I'll put a link right up here. I think it's up here. I'll put a link right up there to Dr. No. I did that reaction. I loved it. I told people that I am used to the James Bond from Roger Moore. I'm from the Roger Moore era of James Bonds. I did not see any Sean Connery movies. I didn't see any Lazenby. I didn't even watch Pierce Brosnan or Timothy Dalton, and I certainly have not seen any of the Daniel Craig Bonds. So I'm in for a wild ride on this channel. So join me as I go on this ride. So guys, we're gonna get right into it. We're not gonna waste any time. We know about James Bond. We know that there's going to be a eccentric villain. There's going to be music. The iconic James Bond theme is gonna play. Now I don't know at what point the songs. I know that they made specific songs four movies. I don't know if this is the point that they did it, but I'm excited about that too, because I love music as well. So guys, without further ado, let's get right into the reaction. But before we do, you gotta do the YouTube thing, guys. Make sure, if you want to support this channel, gotta like and subscribe.
Do it! Just do it!
Now, if you're not convinced about liking, well, actually, you should like the video, come on. But if you're not convinced about subscribing to the channel, then give it to the end of the video. Watch the video, watch the reactions, and maybe even go over my back catalog. Take a look and see what you like. I guarantee you, you'll want to subscribe to the channel. That's how you help support the channel. If you guys like the Big Llama Show hoodie or any other shirts and things that you guys see in the background, go to the Llama Store. It's in the description. As we always do, you know we gotta have some high quality H2O for your movie going experience. Movies are to be enjoyed, and that's what I do here. I love movies, so let's get right into it, guys. Let's not waste any more time. We are watching again 1964 movie From Russia with Love, starring the incomparable Sean Connery. I'm going to see you guys on the other side. Let's get this going. All right, here we go.
It's beans!
Let's go. Oh. Heard that bullet effect before. It's already a game of cat and mouse. Oh shit. Oh no, 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 behind you. Oh, how do you get out of that? Oh, this is a training exercise.
Exactly 1 minute 52 seconds. That's excellent.
Wait, that was a fake James Bond? Alright, we're on location. I've never played chess, and I don't know how. I'd love to learn, but I don't think I have the patience for it.
A brilliant coup.
Damn, he's good.
Siamese fighting fish. Come in, Kronstein. Sit down, number three, while we listen to what number five has devised for us. Number three, is your section ready to carry out Kronstein's directives?
Yes, number one.
This plan is foolproof.
Yes, it is.
In any case, they couldn't possibly pass up even the slightest chance of getting their hands on the Lecter decoder. I think that Spectre will probably have the chance of a personal revenge for the killing of our operative, Dr. No. Because the man the British
will Dr. No, name drop.
Use on a mission of this sort, James Bond.
Let his death be a particularly unpleasant and humiliating one.
Okay, so you've got multiple villains in this one. Working in Spectre. So that's good. Oh, sorry. I'm interrupted by a Bond lady. Hello. So anyway, as I was saying, multiple villains. That's good. You've got like a Dr. Evil type villain petting the cat. All secret espionage. A little bit confusing at first, but I think I understand. At this point, it's not hard to figure out who to trust. But...
is the man I requested ready?
His dossier.
Look at that.
But there is no
super spy training.
I agree. We use live targets as well.
I love this. This is random. Grant is wearing nothing but a towel. You better be careful, sir. She can put the brass knucks on?
He seems fit enough. Have him report to me in Istanbul in 24 hours.
Wait. A brass knucks punch to the stomach gives you the proof that he's fit. Das vidanya. That's the only Russian word I know. I think it means goodbye. This must be the operative. You know, I have made the comments about 60s and 70s films, how they love to like establish locales and locations and give you like a sense of the territory. Look at them glasses, them Coke bottle glasses.
Your work record is excellent.
Not like these.
The state is proud of you.
Thank you, comrade.
From now on, okay. You can do anything he says.
And if I refuse?
Then you will not leave this room alive.
Damn. That's an offer you can't refuse.
I have to make a phone call.
But we haven't eaten yet. I'm starving.
That's tough shit, buddy. Gonna make that call.
Come in, Univex. James Bond here. Well, I've just been reviewing an old case.
Oh, so I'm an old case now, am I?
Shh, it's the office.
I haven't seen you for 6 months.
Damn, James.
I'll be there in an hour. Now, about that lunch.
James Bond, always got a little time for that action. Always got a little time for the peace.
For my next move. No, it's some sort of trap. Well, it's obviously trap. It's a threat. And the bait is a cipher machine. A brand new Lector. A Lector, no less. The whole thing's so fantastic, it just could be true.
An ordinary black leather case with 20 rounds of ammunition here and here. Flat throwing knife. Press that button there. Now she comes. And an AR-7 folding sniper's rifle.
Damn.
0.25 caliber.
Got a sniper rifle in there?
Then if you pull out these straps, inside are 50 gold sovereigns. 25 in either side. Inside a tear gas cartridge. That goes in the case against the side here like that. Turn the catches horizontally.
That's a lot to remember.
Then open normally.
In the heat of the moment, that's a lot to remember.
The same, take it with you. Good luck, 007.
007 never wants the gadgets, but he needs them.
Darling Moneypenny, you know I never even look at another woman.
Oh, really, James?
Bullshit, James.
Let me tell you the secret of the world.
From Russia with Love, there's the title drop.
Ciao.
When they say the title of a movie in the movie.
And then the music hits.
Let's get in base and a car for you, sir.
Oh, shit.
Oh, fine. Can I borrow a match?
Oh, henchman watching.
Come in, come in. Glad to see you. Welcome to Istanbul. All of my key employees are my sons. Blood is the best security in this business.
You must have quite an establishment here.
My friend, if you really want my advice, You should spend a few pleasant days with us here in Istanbul.
Now scope out the amenities. To tell you that the phone is tapped? Oh,
good
shit.
Work. Who can the Russians suspect but the British?
You are not glad to see me this morning, Sheree.
Overjoyed.
Oh! What was that?
I cannot understand a certain breach of the truce. It's unlike our Russian friends to break the peace this way.
Most inconsiderate.
Oh shit, there's rats in there? Gross.
Underneath the Russian consulate. A present from your navy.
So they got like a submarine?
He's giving him a hell of a blowing
periscope?
It's too bad we can't hear as well as see.
Well, from this angle, things are shaping up nicely.
Yes, sir.
You like my gypsy friends. I use them like the Russians use the Bulgars.
All right, so... Oh, my God. So there's a S.P.E.C.T.R.E. plan and agents. Then there's the Russian agents and henchmen. I will say, Bond movies have some very... very attractive women. I can do that with my belly, but you guys, it doesn't look nearly the same. It looks kind of nasty. This guy just wants to peek. Oh. What do you get him with? Dagger? This guy's Call of Duty good. He kills for pleasure. And then here's the other guys. Shake it for daddy. Shake it. He's not impressed. He doesn't show like he's impressed.
Deborah.
Yes, sir. You're gonna fight to the death?
Sandra.
They're not belly dancing. They're about to bust each other up. Couple of 7, he's just like, what do I do? Russians came in blast. There is a lot happening. Just a random slap at James Bond. Gypsies ran the Russians back.
Did you get Krylenko?
No.
I mean, the budget for the movie has definitely increased. Like, the budget from the last movie to this one?
You are now his son.
As if I didn't have enough problems.
Now he's going to decide which gypsy marries the local chief's son?
Barbara said for you to decide. So decide.
You know, that's not a bad problem to have. It's not a...
This might take some time.
You know, he's going to ruin both girls for the chief's son, but if anyone can make a decision, it's James.
I'm already too much in your debt.
How can a friend be in debt?
Oh, here we go. Sniper rifle.
Do you notice anything?
Not yet.
She has a lovely mouth, that Anita.
Yes. Yes. Quick, he's coming.
Wait till he gets on the rope. Now. Whoa, come on, couple more shots.
She should have kept her mouth shut.
Again, James Bond, king of the one-liners. The 80s one-liners have nothing on James Bond, these first two movies. Oh. I didn't know there was spiciness in James Bond movies. I mean, I knew there was spiciness, but... She was butt-ass naked.
You're one of the most beautiful girls I've ever seen.
Thank you, but I think my mouth is too big.
No, it's the right size.
Oh.
For me, that is.
Oh.
A decoding machine, Lecter.
Must we talk about it now?
James is getting some loving tonight, or every night. He's James Bond. You dirty guys, you dirty boys. Okay, so she has those plans, laid them down.
I promise you it wasn't one of my men who killed you. My dear James,
you're not using this.
Yeah, exactly.
It all sounds too easy to me.
I mean, okay, so the clues are right there. It's clear what needs to be done. He's being set up, and he knows he's being set up, but he's not doing anything about it. I don't know. It seems like, again, the British want to spring the trap, and that's fine. But it all seems so simple that why would he fall for it? And I don't think he, I don't know. I don't know if he is or isn't. I'm confused at this point.
Talking to this. Answer my questions quietly, but clearly. Keys.
Symbol or code keys?
Both.
Hmm. There are 24 symbols. Sickness, James. Will you make love to me all the time in England?
Day and night. Go on about the mechanism.
Oh, yes, the mechanism. Once when it was being prepared.
He answered that real quick.
Oh, once when I was with Em in Tokyo, we had an interesting experience.
Thank you, Miss Moneypenny. That's all.
So the secret's out. He was with Moneypenny, with Em.
You did say your clock was correct.
Russian clocks are always correct.
Is this the Lecter?
Well, he's got what he came for. Now. Escape. Oh, no, 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 no. Oh, no, 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 no. Nope, nope, nope. Oh, hail to the no, no.
Quickly.
Oh, shit. They spotted her.
Come on, never mind.
Hurry!
Come on, get on the train. He's gonna get on there and look and find out what happened. Oh, shit.
Yes?
Keep the door locked. I'll knock three times.
Okay.
There's my ticket. Lots of money. Oh.
You are the friend of Karim Bey?
Yes.
There's been a terrible accident.
Oh,
please come with me.
No. The dude got Karim.
Later. Keep the door locked.
They killed each other.
Damn, right in the back, Karim? Stabbed you right in the back.
You're doing this under orders, I know. What are they?
I don't know what you mean.
Liar.
Oh! James with the right cross!
You kill me. I can say nothing. I love you.
Just tell me.
I love you. I love you. It's true.
Oh, shit. She fell in love with a gentleman spy. Even after he smacked the shit out of her. He's telling her, she's telling him he loves her. Oh shit, there he is. Oh, there's the briefcase. Same one? I can't hear a thing they're saying.
Oh, I'm so sorry. I only got M's wire an hour ago. I busted every record getting here.
So James thinks this is that contact that he was supposed to meet. Come on, man. You're matching wits with James Bond.
Waiter.
Oh. Why'd he drug her? More like drugs? Come on, James. You should know this better than anybody.
Stuff you put in a drink.
Exactly. Chloral I saw hydrate. You.
Quick but mild.
And?
Take it easy, R7.
20 miles from here.
Damn. Now shoot him. Yeah, I don't want 007 to die, but the hint, the bad guy always makes this bad plan. Shoot him. End of the movie. Goodbye. He is straight up ganking him. Took everything he's got.
Keep still. We should call each other. Of course.
Spectre.
And it wasn't a Russian show at all.
I get a kick out of watching the great James Bond find out what a bloody fool he's been making of himself.
Exactly. But like you knew James Bond.
Isn't she working for S.P.E.C.T.R.E. too?
No. She thinks she's doing it all for Mother Russia. Was.
Oh.
That works for S.P.E.C.T.R.E. now.
See.
The girl doesn't know that.
So, at this point in the movie, this is the prototypical villain monologue that tells the hero everything he needs to know about the mission, and also the audience lets him in on the secret. But we already knew the secrets. We already knew who was working for who. So there was really no reason for him to go like gushing about the entire plan. And now that James Bond knows the plan, how could this backfire? Maybe he doesn't kill James Bond, which he's not going to.
Tell me, which lunatic asylum did they get you out of?
Damn!
My orders are to kill you.
That is one wicked backhand.
Do, it's
oh shit, oh shit. He stomped on his ass. There it is. Oh, he's choking him with his own rope?
Won't be needing this. Old man.
Who you calling old, bitch? Who you calling old, bitch? Old man did a number on him. Oh, we got a chopper. Chopper heading in. Oh, shit. He's going to throw a grenade from there? Copter.
Time straddled the truck.
Oh, two? Double fisted. Oh. Stopping fast. The filming of this is pretty intense, pretty fun. You know, and it's all practical, looks like, for the most part. Let's get that sniper rifle. Oh no! Oh. You fucked around and found out. You messed up. Oh. Man, with a grenade, pull the pin and throw it. You can't hold it. You don't be cooking a grenade inside of a chopper.
I'd say one of their aircraft is missing.
Again, I'd say one of their aircraft is missing. Such great one-liners. James Bond put on the hat and everything. I'm the captain now. You're gonna cut him free and let him swim?
Just isn't your day, is it?
Uh-oh.
Three men were found dead on the train at Trieste. One of them
possible. It was perfect.
Except for one thing.
Yeah.
We're dealing with Bond.
Bond is still alive and the Lector is not yet in our possession. I warned you.
Oh, shit.
We do not tolerate failure, number three. You know the penalty.
Yes.
If you fail,
you die.
Number three.
Yes.
I do not wish to have to tell the Russians that there will be another delay.
Jacked out of her mind. She's terrified. Just watch number five get his ass handed to him.
Which?
Steve, go!
Now we got a boat chase. Oh shit! It's an RPG. Oh, this looks like reminiscent of Jaws.
Hands up, Mr. Bond.
Why are you giving up? Without those drums, the boat must be lighter.
Take that. Holy shit! Damn.
Where there's smoke, there's fire.
Where there's smoke, there's fire. Oh, shit! Boom. Oh, that dude's on fire. Hey, it's Kleb.
Thank you.
It's Kleb. Don't let her in.
Be back, will you? What was that?
Hello, what was that you were saying?
Look at that.
Hello, hello.
Final double cross right here. Now, the question is the Russian in? Is she in on it?
Romanova.
Oh, James, get your heart broken. I mean, I don't think she's in on it. I think she's just doing her job. Watch out, watch out. You got the venom in that boot.
What?
She's not much of a fighter. Shoot her. Shoot her in the face. Come on, Romano. Where'd she get her? Where'd she get her? Yeah, I'll take that.
Yes. She's had her kicks.
Oh, my God. He ended it with a she's had her kicks. I love it. I absolutely love it.
Is it?
I'll show you.
Faces, you haunted me so.
The end.
Still my.
Not quite the end. James Bond will return in Goldfinger. That's the next one for me. Okay, so that was From Russia with Love. There's my reaction to it. I've got some thoughts, and I can't wait to talk about it. Let's talk about it. All right, so there's my reaction to From Russia with Love, the 1964 movie starring Sean Connery as James Bond. So, what's fun about these Bond movies is a couple of things that are stereotypical now, but back then I'm sure were pretty exciting. Well, first of all, the eccentric bad guy, right? Who was leading Spectre was so much fun. It was fun. He was petting the cat. You had number five, you had number one, you had so many bad guys. I think that's my only concern about the movie, is there were so many like bad guys. There was the Russian element who wasn't part of Spectre but was also part of trying to, you know, get this Lecter.
English is not his first language.
And then, you know, you had the Russian double cross, and you had the Spectre, and then you had the
English motherfucker, do you speak it?
Yes.
You know, a blonde guy who was the assassin. So many things going on. Great, great thriller, great spy. The only thing I didn't like was there's, you know, the whole thing about, how James Bond should know that this is a setup, that he should know that it's too obvious. And so I'm not sure what they were going with that. From an audience perspective, it was pretty obvious that it was a setup because they told you it was. I probably would have enjoyed it a lot more if I didn't know the setups, right? Like if I just thought and then they find a way to reveal it. But I get that in the movie you have to try to kind of let the audience know the story. You gotta tell the story for all audiences. Overall, way, way up in the budget in terms from Dr. No. The action sequences were great. They were phenomenal. It upped the ante in terms of the spy. The death count was much higher. So it was very interesting to sort of watch and see the evolution from the first movie to this one. There is the definite evolution. James Bond is a more sophisticated character, I believe, in this one than he was in the first. But the one thing it's funny is his catchy one-liners. He's like an Arnold Schwarzenegger of the 60s. Like, it's crazy how he had a one-liner for everything. I think I highlighted him in the reaction. Overall, loved it. Loved it. It definitely was on my toes. It was very, very tense. Very interesting, the story and the characters. Beautiful women. Beautiful women in this one. James Bond, again... The debonair ladies' man, the gentleman spy, does his thing. So overall, I enjoyed it. I thought it was a great movie. I can't wait. See what this did was got me excited for the next one, which is Goldfinger. I don't know anything about Goldfinger, but the fact that they teased it at the very end gives me sort of that anticipation. So I can only imagine what it was like in 1964 to go to the theater or go watch this movie and see on the credits that, hey, the end, not quite yet, Goldfinger is next. You're like, oh my God, now how long do I have to wait for Goldfinger? Now, I know it took about 2 years between movies, so I'm not sure what the release time was between this one and Goldfinger, but you start to see the stereotypes being amplified. And the last thing I'll mention is the main assassin, goes on this monologue about what he's doing and why he's doing, revealing to James Bond everything that's happening, the double cross. It's a stereotypical, or it's a movie trope that's used over and over again, where the villain monologues too long and the hero gets away. Kind of funny to see it that way. Anyway, I enjoyed it. I would say this one is a 4.5 out of 5. Really did enjoy this one. I can't wait to watch Goldfinger. So that's going to be next on the channel for me, will be Goldfinger. I'll be reacting to that one next. So guys, that's the commentary immediately following. Let's get right into the IMDb trivia. Let's look at the box office and do a couple pieces of trivia, and then we'll close up the show. Here we go. All right, trivia time. So looking at this, it says here, first of all, Sir Sean Connery, he was knighted. So Sir Sean Connery called this movie his personal favorite Bond film. It was fun. Oh, look at this. The knife shoe used by Rosa Klebb was an actual weapon used by the KGB. So it's a real life thing. That's pretty interesting. I thought it was just a movie thing. And she got her kicks. All right, it says here, Sir Sean Connery was outfitted for this movie with 8 specialty tailored Seville Row suits. Each one of them were costing $2,000 a piece. That's crazy. Oh, look at this. Steven Spielberg was convinced to cast Robert Shaw, the bad guy here, the assassin in this movie, in Jaws after watching him in this movie. Now, his dialogue, there wasn't much to his dialogue. He only had that one monologue, but man, I didn't realize that was Robert Shaw. I didn't realize that was the guy from Jaws. Crazy. This is crazy trivia right here. Final James Bond movie that was actually viewed by Ian Fleming. So the author's, final viewing of a movie was this one. Not a movie, but the Bond movie was this one. So this is cool. And this is what we're gonna transition from this to the box office. It says here, this movie broke box office records and was responsible for launching Sean Connery into a major star. This was, again, higher grossing and probably more star-studded than Dr. No. So this was the launching point for Sean Connery. All right, so looking at the box office, this movie cost, it says here, production budget was $2 million. Its worldwide box office, given domestic, well, let's look at worldwide, $78 million, made $24 million domestically, and international box office accounted for $54 million of that total. Definitely made its money back and then some, and understandably, they had to launch a sequel right after. So I'm interested in that. Now, one thing I will say is it is under the MPAA rating as a PG rating, which again, it for today's standards is kind of tame, but there was some nudity in there. And I guess between PG and PG-13 back in the 70s and early 80s, there was nudity allowed. But again, I just found that kind of odd that it was a PG movie. It had that in there. They did kill and they did do some things. But again, the rating system was always kind of loopy until they did some course correction. All right, guys. Well, listen, that's my reaction. That's my commentary. That's the trivia. That's the box office. Everything we got for today's show. I hope you enjoyed this presentation of From Russia with Love, the 1964 007 classic with Sean Connery. I enjoyed it, had a great time. I hope you did too. Guys, this channel was created for the love of movies. I made this channel so that I can share my love of movies and my experiences and my thoughts with you, so that if you love movies the way that I love movies, this is the channel for you. Guys, if you liked this review, if you like this commentary, if you like these types of videos, give it a like and subscribe. Subscribe to the channel. That's how you support the Big Llama's mission of spreading the love of movies to everybody. I've got goals to try to do this full time, but guys, if you want to support the channel, that's how you do it. You like and subscribe. Guys, thank you so much for joining me on this journey today. I hope you enjoyed it. I'm the Big Llama. This is the Big Llama Show. And guys, remember, be kind, rewind. It's movie night, and we're going to see you on the next one.
First off, I don't care what you people say, never follow.